update. It is still the 28th, just later in the day. It is 6:30. I think when I last chatted with you guys, it was, I have no idea, honestly, but it was earlier, much earlier. I finished chapter 13. That makes me really happy. Oh my God, I'm so tired. It was a very emotional chapter, and I had so many edits in this one. However, they were all really good edits, so I'm really happy with the final product. I'm so happy I got through this today. I'm so happy I'm done with 13. Oh, now I get to eat dinner. Yay, and my husband should be home in like a couple of hours, so that's a double yay. Oh, no yay for working this weekend, but yay for hopefully getting some more chapters done. I'm gonna go watch The Tudors. I have earned a break. It's Friday, and I'm pretty sure it's Memorial Day weekend right now. I think it's a 3-day weekend, but probably just gonna work. Although it is my anniversary this weekend, so I won't work on Sunday. I'll take Sunday off, but I'll probably work Monday. Okay, guys, bye. Hi guys, it is June 3rd. I talked to you guys and checked in last Friday, and I was all, I'm gonna work all weekend, but then my husband came home and I only worked a little bit, and I'm not too mad about that. Actually, I needed that break. I got work done yesterday and the day before. We didn't really do anything for Memorial Day. We just kinda chilled. And last night, we were supposed to have a date night. We were going to like this candlelit concert that was going to be a quartet playing Mozart's most famous pieces. And then I was rushing down the stairs because we decided to bike to the venue. Chicago has bikes you can borrow. And I was running back upstairs to get our helmets because safety first. And then I was going down the stairs in our building, and the last three steps, I slipped, twisted my ankle, and fell very ungracefully to the floor. And now I have a sprained ankle. So I am working from my couch. And I will be on this couch for the next week. So that's so cool. So cool. Hopefully I will only have this boot on for a week. I go and check in the doctors next Wednesday. This sucks. I'm tired. I slept like such shit last night. It is not fun to sleep with a boot on. And the doctor suggested I do that because it just provides extra stability. I don't want to like twist it and hurt it more accidentally outside of the boot. So pretty much resigning myself to a week of awful sleep. But my husband's being lovely. And well, I would say my cats are being lovely, but they're just kind of confused as to why I have a thing on my boot and I'm not playing with them. Just wanted to give this update, and I will talk to you guys later. I'm on chapter 15, over halfway through. I'll finish it today and start on 16, so, and 16 is the halfway point. Okay, bye. Hello. It is June 14th. I am going to finish editing this week and I'm so excited. I had a setback, namely in the form of spraining my ankle, which was not fun. Pretty sure I already reviewed that with you guys. But I am so excited to not be in this stupid boot anymore, which will hopefully be soon. I'm walking on it without any crutches, which is awesome because I'm really grown to despise them. But I am going to finish editing this week. I have made so much progress within the last 10 days. It's been so nice. I didn't realize that I was like really missing a game plan, and my husband and I kind of like stepped aside, had a talk, figured out a plan, not just for this book and its release, but the next book. And that just kind of like put that final fire I need of a visitor to get things finished. I think I'm somewhere around 25,000 words left to edit. This week is busy. I have a haircut, which is going to take some time. Anybody with long, thick hair, like myself, knows that if you are getting any color treatment done, it'll literally take hours for me to get my hair cut, and I have it scheduled for the afternoon. So I'm gonna have to bust out a lot of work in the morning. I'm working late tonight. I'm working late tomorrow. Wednesday, I'm working average because we have friends coming over, and Friday night we have a wedding. So I just have to hunker down today and tomorrow. I'm gonna try and knock out as much as I can. So I can be done. I have to get ready to contact my alpha readers formally so that I can get them this copy of the manuscript. And then my editors are going to be able to take it July 19th, which is not when I would have liked, but it is their only availability. I thought I had requested it early enough, like sent in a request to ask for availability early enough, but clearly it was not. Constantly learning, and I will be better prepared next time. So the plan is roughly get this manuscript to my alphas, let them know that it has not been fully edited. I have a few questions that are like pretty pointed and specific that I would like each alpha reader to kind of like take on, not even questions, but just viewpoints, if they could pay attention to the main character's relationship. How does that progress for them? Does it feel natural? Does it lag? Did they want more? Could it have been less? What about like the background plot? I would love for my alphas to find any little plot holes. And I have a couple others saved on my computer. Once they get it, and after I get that back, I mean, I think I will get it back. I feel like I will get back their comments and critiques before July 19th. And I'm going to wait until after that first, my big round of copy and line edits is done by my editor. And then I'm going to send that off to my betas. My betas will probably then have a little bit shorter of a time span, but they will be reading more for overall flow. There's not going to be like a super specific viewpoint that I want them to like pay attention through the entire time, although they will get a small questionnaire at the end. That way I can kind of see if I have resolved any of the issues found by my alpha readers, or if I had any lingering concerns that they are addressed. Goes back to my editors. They have a like one person, kind of like one man job. They offer a beta reading as well. Then I will get a proofread. Then that copy will go out to an advanced reader group. And I'm struggling trying to find the right, how long I should give those ARC readers to actually read the book. Because I'm thinking maybe 2 weeks. So that I can then release this book. With everything, with all of those edits, some of them overlapping and others not needing their own time and whatnot, I think it's going to be an early September release, which is not what I wanted. My husband and I really thought we were going to be able to get it out in like August, but my editors are just busy. And I don't want to rush my reading team, although maybe I should just ask. I think maybe that is the way to go, especially because I have so many positions to fill. I think I can just be a little more upfront in my survey when I survey people who actually want to join, if they are confident that they can finish in a certain time span. And I know my books are a bit longer than the average romance, so I just want to be conscious of that. But I'm really excited. I think I've shown it before, but this, look, that's all I have left compared to this chunk. Oh, it feels so good. What are you doing? Hey, you can't fit. There's no space for you on my desk. Hey. So anyway, that's the tea. Looks like an early September release. But what I'm most excited about is that on Monday, on the 21st, June 21st, I am going to start plotting for the next book, titled To Be Determined. I'm having a real rough time deciding on the name of the next book. And after I finish plotting it, writing it. My husband and I did not just come up with like a timeline for this editing, although I think we did parse it out pretty well with what is to be expected. I'm still waiting to hear back from my editors on what their estimate is for how fast they can get it done. But if I can just meet my writing goals, then I think early next year, like January or February, I will have the second book out. And that's just giving myself holiday cushion, to be honest, and some cushion for my editors if I don't get them in time. But I got some big goals. I'm ready to fucking work. Pardon my French, but 2020 just kind of really threw me off my writing rhythm and my editing rhythm. The system my husband and I recently came up with just to try and be more efficient and more confident in my editing, so I always just feel so daunted by it, has worked wonders. So I'm excited to like put some new energy and new tricks into writing next book. Okay, I should get back to editing. You know, it never ends. I'm very close to hitting today's word count quota and surpassing it. That is going to be the key to breathing this week, is just surpassing all of my all of my editing quotas. And today I had like a 7,000 word quota. I'm gonna try and just smash it out. So I'm gonna get to that, probably with a glass of wine. No big deal. Goodbye.